I know, Commissioner. I've really just been kind of not very busy lately. But, yeah, you've just been having a nice Memorial Day barbecue, too, just like me. Yeah, I should have stopped by. But, I got the Bat Buddies here again. Yeah, a few of them linger in, and they want me to make another utility bill. You know, the Joker's always taking the one I got. Can't have enough extra spares, right? So I'll talk to you later. You have a great Memorial Day weekend. And just so you know, the butler is not here any longer. That mysterious voice on the phone, it'll have to be me. So if, you know, if it goes to voicemail, you'll understand. Well, no rush. Could go down the poles. But, nah, I'm just gonna go and make another bill. People have been asking. Thanks, guys. I appreciate you being encouraging. Let's see. So many of you Bat Buddies are letting me down. But some have registered in, and you're really bringing me up. A couple of people have talked to me about they want to see me just keep on doing more of the same. So, I guess I will for now. Why not the rest of you submit like a question for the contest? Try to build this up a little bit. Even the ones that are encouraging really haven't even done that yet. Remember, email me at artsee1@earthlink.net. That way, nobody else knows what the questions are in advance, and no one's going to judge me on whether I should have selected a different question. It's my thing, you know? All right, anyway. So and more than that. But the reason I'm saying this is because they were having a garage sale, and I guess the guy there had been like a cabinet maker, and he was like retiring or whatever. I bought like, I'd say about 20-something things of stain. I didn't buy them all. I just bought the ones that were, you know, pretty full and looked pretty good. They said each one's $1, so I grabbed just about every one, but I left a few. I don't know, I could have bought more. But what are you going to do with 20 things of stain? I've been fixing things around here, that's for sure. The reason I bring it up is because I went back, because it's garbage day today, and I wanted to see, maybe they're throwing away the rest of the stuff. And they did throw away a few things, mostly junk. But, there again, junk! We need junk, don't we? Yeah, what's junk mean? Junk means you make something for free. So let's do a belt. So let me just show you some things. I picked out some really stupid looking stuff, and I did it on purpose. Look at this. Just in case Batman needs to comb his hair. Looks pretty cool though. This is about as elementary and it's even pink as you can get. Various things. I made a bat in case I need it for the symbol. Look at this. This is pretty cool opening thing. It's got some stuff in there. Obviously, it's just the right size for this. I thought I'd take this old rasp and make maybe a little Batman communicator. It looks like the microphone part. I tore this off. Little toy as I was walking the dog today. Just various things, little buttons. Just different stuff. This is cool. I don't know what you'd do with it, you know, but my old selfie stick that I used for above broke. There it is. I got another one now, but just different stuff. And I thought for fun, I'd take this old dollhouse piano and try to put it on there, but that's getting absolutely ridiculous, so I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to stain that. I've been working some stain. Oh, I'm working on, got some irregulars here with my gauntlets. Just been fooling with that. I made a couple of gauntlet masters, and I needed urethane to do one because it would flex to get out of the mold. So I had a little bit of urethane left over, so I've been just fooling around, making some stuff, and I get so irritated. You know, I'm a master for 30 years of latex. But I know there's plenty of masters out there at urethane, and I ain't one of them, but I don't really want to be, but every once in a while I get my hands on it and make a belt. Little puffy things coming out of here, a little degassing. Gassing off, you know, if you don't get it mixed just right or the humidity's too much, it's so sensitive. So I saved these just for fun. This one's got all kinds of little bumps, and this one looks like it's just dying away. I don't know what happened there. I thought I'd go down and talk to them about it and see if maybe they'll take pity on me and give me a discount and get some more stuff. But I really wasn't able to make hardly anything out of it. I cut the ends off. Maybe I'll just put that on there and I'll just make this into a partial belt and just get rid of it. Always got things around here I gotta get rid of. Okay, but let's get started. I've got this piece of vinyl. I got like 6 rolls of vinyl that I picked up on the side of the street. I figured I'd just go ahead and start using it, you know, because it's not leather. I got a couple leather couches. They're not leather either, sitting, you know, just a little ways down the street. Driving by my daughter, I said I'd go pick them up, and I went and felt it, and I go, it's not good enough. So, at least this is brand new vinyl. I'll go ahead and pull that over, use that for a base. Obviously, we don't want a white belt, but I'll do some kind of modulation thing with it. So I don't really know what I'm gonna do, but I thought I'd get started on this video anyway and put it out there. I'm not gonna do the video on these just yet. I'm not quite ready, but I will. And just say, hey, Bat Buddies, I'm here. I'm trying to run this contest thing. It's gonna be small. You guys decide that based on what you do. This is cool. Ivory carving blocks. I don't know, there's enough of them. Whenever you get something that's a whole bunch of the same thing, you can always line them up and make them look kind of cool. I don't know, you know, different things. I don't know what the heck these are. I mean, I use them for lights and stuff like that. But why would somebody have these? Anyway, different things. I'll put them together. I don't know, should I show how I work it out? It's kind of boring. Maybe I just like kind of lay it out and then get back with you. Let's start off with the structure, okay? You know, I have tons of these. In fact, I gave up getting even more tons of them recently. Got it put together here. I'm gonna make this a little bit tougher. This could be the inside part, okay? Look how easy it is to break that. And so that's gonna be the inside part. And then we're gonna take and we're gonna put this vinyl around it. So you'll have like, you know, if I had leather, I wouldn't have to do this. If I had nice tough leather, I wouldn't have to do this. But I don't. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just say, okay, well, how far? Like that, all right. So I'm gonna wanna have it fold over once. I'm gonna go ahead and for this and just, you know, I say everything is free, but really, some, you know, what happens is I buy something because I have to have it for a project. And then if I don't use it again, it goes to waste. So really, what I'm doing is I'm paying for whatever I have to do for the project, and then whatever my leftovers are, I've already paid for it. I've already got paid. It was the cost of doing business. So in that sense, it's still free. I don't expect you to have all these things laying around, though. But I'm sure if you're doing other household projects and stuff, you probably do. So anyway, I'll make the curve go the same way like that. It's like curve outward. This is one of those vertical blinds, okay? Basically, you want your belt to be about, all right, that's 35. This will work for almost all people because you can just add Velcro or a belt over top of it. So I'm going to go ahead and just, I'm going to ahead and cut this. Where's my Sharpie? Okay, there. All right, so I'll just make some crude marks. Okay, so I say, okay, this is where it is right now. I have to go over just, I don't know, let's go several times. We have the room to go three times. Might as well go three times. So we know that that'll go. Go ahead and make sure I have enough to go three times over. This is kind of boring, but I want you to just know a little bit of some of the stuff that I do. Take my trusty ruler. I used to have one of these in art school, but I don't know what happened to mine. But my best friend died in a car accident, my roommate, and I went and grabbed this, you know, and wanted to remember him. Something he used, put his hands on every day, you know. And you know, they say these Sharpie markers are permanent, but here's a little story. He had a little drawing on there, and it started to fade. His drawing is completely faded from 35 years ago. And at one point when it was not quite faded, I put a few marks on where they were. And even the few marks that I put on are fading. But, you know, what matters is, you know what it is. And when you work every day, I don't advise you to go have all the best stuff. I advise you to have things that mean something to you. I did do a video on my workshop when I first put it together about 5 years ago. I emphasized, and I should do another one now that I've got a few more people that understand who I am and what I'm doing. I should put another one together and tell you a little bit more about what I was talking about then, which was the importance of the things you have around you meaning something. Because if it means something, well, you know, I was talking to one of my Bat Buddies, gave me a comment, and he says, yeah, I totally understand how you could be lonely in the cave. He says, I'm in a big rig all day. Well, that's really something. I never really thought of it like that. You know, you might not be in a cave like me, but you get your own story. Thanks for sharing it with me. Makes me feel a little bit better, like I'm whining about nothing. But in all fairness, if I wasn't whining, I wouldn't be doing this with you guys, you know? And I want to do this with you guys, and I think some of you guys want to do this with me. So, that's just great, you know? The relationship works. But like I was talking to a few Bat Buddies and saying, you know, my problem is, have I done what I need to do on this channel? Can I keep being creative? And should I even keep taking the time to be creative? I don't know.
You know, one of my bat buddies over in England says, man, this is the time you should just be making money. Think about yourself. You know, the golden years are coming. Yeah. But, you know, some people prepare for their golden years and never even get there. I don't want that to happen to me. You know, the Stoic philosophers, I know I got at least one bat buddy as a fan. they believe life as you live it needs to be very important because it's all you're sure of. And, you know, there's something to be said for that. You got to plan for the future, but you got to also live for the now. And so my looking at everything negatively with this might not be the best approach for me. I should see the glasses half full. Thank you for your encouragement. I'm not guaranteeing you're going to be able to do that because I may be doing other things, but you know, I appreciate you looking for the things to say that you know I'm going to want to hear. That really shows me that you're hearing me and you're thinking about me. And you know, I'll tell you, when I'm working on this and I'm in the cave here, I want you to know I'm thinking about you too. You know, I always thought to myself, is Adam West, is he aware that I'm going to be him one day? Is he aware that I'm riding my big wheel and pretending to be him right now and preparing, you know? Is he aware of these things? Can he talk to me, you know? Can he see me through this? You know, I when I was young, I thought it was real. I thought it was all real, you know? I thought he could maybe see me. He never acknowledged my presence, but, you know, I want to acknowledge your presence, bet buddies. I appreciate you guys. This is a different kind of a way when this works like this. And I want to make it so it works special like that. And I appreciate you saying the things you do and get me through another day feeling better about myself and what I'm doing. A bat buddy from Germany says, yeah, you make an impact. You know, it's important to me. My favorite channel to watch. I go, I can't believe this is your favorite channel, but thank you for saying that. So we have something nice to work with, not something nice and solid there. I could have made it so that this was right on the edge, but you're not going to see that. Every time you do something different, like this would be like a prototype. You go, okay, I'll think about that next time if I do another one. But I never do another one, do I? That's the fun. There's no sense in having it be that thick. These are cool, but not very Batman-esque. This is, of course. Ooh, nice. That almost is cool. But this would be too thick for the buckle. So, I also like these things being up there like that. Just thinking right now, obviously those will make a pouch if I want there to be one. Remember the days of the labeler? 1990? Gosh, I would have thought 70s, but okay. Somebody took the time to label their comb. Well, it looks more like a patch side. That or that? I think it needs to flip up. I don't know. There's something else can be here. I don't know what at this point. I like how this goes over. Cover girl. Yeah, nice. I'm sure that that'll make it look like a flap that could go up. It comes off of this? No, not something else. This is great because if I make something like the, you know, the little bat radio that goes inside of there, that'd be cool because that would hold it. So thinking with that in mind, I may come up with an idea, little pieces of latex everywhere, of something that's gonna need to go in there. Maybe that with another thing on top of it. This is, I'm just kind of, every time I do this a little differently, I'm just showing you how I think because, you know, sometimes I just do the finishing because people like that. Sometimes people might say, oh, you left this part out. What were you thinking about? You know, so I'm saying, okay, I'll talk about what I'm thinking. Okay, so I got three of these. You could make one that was perfect with one on each side, or you could cut them down and use all three. You know, there's something to be said about, okay, so what if it doesn't have the thing on the bottom? And something to be said with having three that match. That's kind of nice. This one's a little bit messed up. You know, just like a Christmas story, just stick it in the corner. Yeah, I think I'll go with the three. This is so stupid, I gotta get it on there somehow. Maybe it'll be a part of, no, that's too big. One, two, three. You know, being Batman is easy as one, two, three, but only if you're a millionaire, billionaire, whatever. Okay, so it is easy, one, two, three. This came off of something around here, and I can't find out what it came off of. So I figured, oh, I'll stick it on here. If I ever figure out what it was, at least I know where it is. I can go get it again. Yeah. And this isn't going to do anything for me. This is too obvious what it is. I keep wanting to use this, and I never really come up with an idea. Maybe I will for the Bat Radio. I'm not sure. So I start doing process of elimination. I start saying, okay, what have I got to work with? What have I got so far? What else do I need? I can always go and get more stuff. That's easy enough. Look at that. Look at that. Nobody knows that's a stapler. Nobody knows, because who makes a stapler that small? That's a... Oh, that's a... That's a... A pulse oximeter. Yeah, no. I don't know what it is, but by golly... It does something. This came off my tripod. I am so in need of a new tripod. Still thinking about the radio, what the radio will need. This is cool. This is cool. I can always get rid of... See how all of a sudden I get rid of those numbers all at once if I wanted to. You know, there wouldn't have to be any numbers. I almost feel like I should just go down here and get rid of some of the numbers and keep the 1, 2, 3 because I like that. I can make multiple things out of this and you wouldn't ever know in the end that it's a ruler. So that kind of thing is what I think about, you know. You guys ever seen Problem Child 2? You know, this all started. Okay, let me just remind you guys, because some of you guys are brand new. This all started in first and second grade. If I was doing my own question for the trivia contest, I'd probably use this one. What's this called? And when did I, what's the story behind it? Okay. Well, I'll just tell you, this is a thingamajig. This is what we did first and second grade in order to have toys in the classroom because toys weren't allowed. And this was the very first model. And then everything just went on for, it seemed like weeks, forever, making new stuff all the time. Well, I kind of went through life as an artist, drawing on the drawing board and stuff like this. And I really didn't use my hands again until I got on the movies. And if you saw Problem Child 2 and you saw that space shuttle bunk bed that Junior uses, that's me. And the director was so thrilled with it, with all the stuff that I did and designing the whole thing, that he actually extended the bedroom. He got extra additional funding for it and even put a special scene in of him using the bed to emphasize how Junior so much likes John Ritter's stuff and doesn't like LaWanda's stuff. Well, that's me. So you just make stuff. You just make stuff and you make it into a reality. And, you know, if you saw Cop and a Half, Devin goes jumping off the top balcony to his hidden police bike down below. That's all me. You look at him in his bedroom and he's playing with stuff that he made because he's going to pretend to be a detective or a police officer. That's all me. Okay. This is, you know, there's only a few people in the world that do this stuff that don't get paid regularly. You know, obviously George Lucas and all those people that were the craftsmen on Star Wars, they were primed. If I was in California, I could have been one of them, but no, I wasn't here. But they made the Death Star, they made all those models, they made things out of nothing, and they made things work, okay? The Death Star is models of everything you've ever seen. That Millennium Falcon is models of everything you've ever seen. Now, I could be doing this with models if I wanted to, you know? But this is all just a way to think, as you start putting something together. So I'm gonna cut this video right now. Let's go back out front. So basically what I'm saying is that's all me. Well, why hasn't it been me my whole life? Well, it kind of was because, like I said, because it kind of really always was the fun part of me as a child. That picture of me standing there with my cape and all my junk in the background. I didn't have that many toys. I creatively played and imagined. I was preparing to actually be Batman like Adam West. Because I, at that young age, riding my big wheel, thought that was the real world. Obviously, I knew, I was also watching Superman reruns, and I knew that there wasn't really a Superman, or I would see him flying around. But I didn't know there wasn't a Batman. So I left kind of that fun stuff there in my childhood. And then I went through schooling, I got my education, and I went to art school. I was always on the drawing board, always just, drive. 15 years drafting, my dad's architectural office, the movies, you know, drafting,
creating props and sets. It was really cool. But what happened was I only got to every once in a while touch on it. Like I said, prop and child cut in half, a couple things like that. And what I've done is, with you guys, when I'm not doing this just because people are asking. I'm doing it because it's fun. What it's doing is allowing me to take a little break from my mundane monotonous, do the same thing over and over again, fulfilling orders, helping bat buddies, and kind of pretend like I'm a child for a little while in this cave. Pretend like I'm actually doing what I was doing when I was in first and second grade again, and even younger than that. As soon as I could pound a nail that I would find at a construction site, my family was builders, and my dad was an architect. There was always little pieces of wood and nails if you want to hammer them back out straight. This is how I started in nursery school, kindergarten. Then went on first and second grade. And then little blowgun things. I don't know if you saw the one on that. When I was on the Mickey Mouse Club, we were always doing that prop stuff too, making whenever we had free time. And there was a lot of free time there because they only needed so much for each episode. And so what I'm really doing here, Bat Buddies, is kind of like playing, but I'm involving you. Because I don't show what I do. Because if I showed what I did, everybody would be doing it. It's already bad enough with all the people that do 3D printing and just crank things out that they get a hold of in urethane over and over again. So the hobby, the fun part of the hobby, for me, is talking with you guys, getting your comments, doing these things, and whatever else I can think of that's fun, I don't mind wasting my time doing, because this isn't about sales and trying to solicit you. This is about opening up my world, Mr. Robert's neighborhood, to you, Bat Buddies. So the ones I'm trying to build, of course we need the numbers. I want to feel like doing something, touching people, right? But the ones I really feel close to are the ones that are hearing Paul Roberts, Artsy One, and communicating back and forth. Because that makes me feel like, okay, my life of what I've done is still talking to people now in these zany ways. To me, that's important. It means more. It might not be like getting a smile from a child that is on a Make-A-Wish Foundation or things like that, which I've done and you've done. You've gone to hospitals, things like that. But you guys and the people that I help when I'm wearing my cape and cowl when I do my counseling, if I can help them, I'm helping you guys. Don't you all have problems? Don't you like to laugh a little bit? Don't you like to be creative? Don't you like to have somebody that empathizes with you and tries to continue to encourage you to be positive? Well, that's Paul Roberts, Artsy One. And I don't know other ways to do it, really, than just kind of sharing little slices. I do know other ways. I've tried other ways. Look, I got 500 videos on here. But my point is, the videos where I share little slices of my life and kind of show practicality out of it, too, those are the ones that I like the best, that are worth doing. This is like my 25th belt now. Come on, it's ridiculous. But why? Because I know there are a few people out there to get something out of it besides myself, and I just like to relate to you guys in that way. I mean, there's other ways too, but that's one of the ways I really like to relate, because I'm having fun on this end. And let's face it, guys, when I'm having my cup of coffee in the morning and about 10 people are responding to a video I've done, and I spend a few minutes having the coffee after I do the Wordle and I reply to your comments, have a little conversation, or you send me an email, shoot me some pictures, whatever. That's all I'm getting out of this that I know of, you know? And that's fine. It has been up till now for 500 videos. Question is, what's gonna come next? I've asked you guys to get excited about the fact we're turning 2,000 subscribers. I've asked you for a question that we can use for a consolation or a secondary prize if I select it. And then the person that gets the right answer would be the main prize. I don't know what those prizes are. I've asked you to do that for me. I've only gotten one email so far. Please don't do it on the comments. If you're gonna do it on the email, because I don't want people to see what the questions are ahead of time or help me to judge which ones they should be. But my point is, if I'm asking and you're not doing then it makes me wonder, am I talking to 1, 5, 10, 15, 20? Certainly not the 200 that show up immediately when I put something on about capes or cowls or some kind of armor or something like that. But I'll do that occasionally when I have something on my desk that I have something to work with and I think of a new way to show something. But I'm not going to do that every day. So it means a lot when I talk to somebody, hear back, and when I ask something and I receive back. It means a lot. I'm kind of surprised. You know, I don't know how to do the bells and whistles and subscription thing. I don't know if you have your alert notification things on or whatever. So I know sometimes it takes a while. It might take like 5-day buffer before you see that I put a video up. That's fine. I'll give you a few more days. But then we're going to roll with this thing one way or another. So right now, I am going to stop this video for today. I'm just rambling. I figure this is the tail end. If you want to listen to it, it's because you got nothing better to do, or maybe you didn't hear what I was saying before, and so you're hearing it now. And then I'll come back, and I've done this before, I'm going to do it again. I'll come back, and I'll do the finishing video separate, only if it's warranted. Weigh in, Bat Buddies. Appreciate it. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One. I'm not feeling like light enough in my happy place to fly out of here right now. So, talk to you later. Maybe soon. You know, I need a muse. Tink, where are you?